This is a 2006 Toyota RAV4 with a 2.4-liter 2AZ-FE engine. That's a four-cylinder engine. This car with the engine running shows the check engine light. It also shows the vehicle stability control and traction control light. Okay, so that's nothing to worry about. Like on many other Toyotas, the stability control and traction control come on with the check engine light. So let's just go check the codes. So the codes we get on this are a P0138, which is a run-of-the-mill O2 sensor code for the rear or downstream O2 sensor. That's very easily handled usually. But we also have a P0606. And for this code, if we look in the factory service manual, the only indication is replace the ECM. There is no other diagnostic or indication. So that's a pretty serious code. However, we're not going to take this too seriously right now. We're just going to go ahead with replacing the rear O2 sensor, which is an inexpensive item, and we'll see if this corrects the problem. I've cleared the codes, restarted the engine. We're going to see if this repair holds, and I will update you on the status. So in order to verify this repair more quickly, I'm going to put the ECU in check mode. Check mode means that DTC will be set immediately instead of having to go through a multiple trip logic. Okay, so this will put us in check mode. Now we'll restart the engine. First, you're going to see that the check engine light is flashing, and this is normal for check mode. Once the engine is started, the flashing light goes off. So running in check mode, I'm not getting any check engine light or any indication if something wrong with the rear O2 sensor, downstream O2 sensor. So I'm gaining confidence that this repair has been effective, and I'll give you a further update later. I have just returned from taking the car for a spin in check mode and no check engine light. And also checking the voltage for the downstream O2 sensor. Everything seems normal. Let's see if I can chart it. So here is a chart in real time of the rear O2 sensor voltage. And it appears to be normal. It's cycling up and down. Let's make it larger. So it really looks like we're doing pretty good now with this O2 sensor. And we hope that this issue is resolved. So that's it for this episode. I hope you found it useful. Thank you for watching.